Hey guys, welcome to Fur Tutorials. So guys, today I create one more time smooth spline animation with using, guys, this time I use Metaball. So guys, firstly I create simple composition. So guys, firstly I take cylinder and change cylinder radius. Guys, cylinder radius I take 500 and height decrease. Height I take like 10. I take simple 10. And height segments you can increase, I take like 10, and rotation segments I take like 200. Yes, so guys, I go to display, select here God shading lines. See guys, that's my cylinder. And now, so guys, go to caps here and segments increase randomly, like I take 50. Yeah, and guys, second object I take tube. Yeah, and increase tube size. Guys, inner radius and outer radius change. Firstly, outer radius increase like 510, and inner radius increase, I take like 490 cm, and decrease this height. Height decrease, yes, simple. I take like 50. Yeah, guys, increase segments, rotation segments increase. And height segments, this one increase. So guys, go to slice now. Okay, so now fill it. Okay, all is good. Okay, guys, now I create animation. So my camera angle like this, simple. Okay, so guys, firstly, same as the last tutorial, guys, I take emitter and up, guys, rotate minus 90 degree and up like this. Guys, y-axis I take like 350. Yes, and select this emitter, select. Guys, birth editor I take 5 and birth render take 5. Yeah, and stop animation I take 1000f. yes, right. And speed, all is good. Guys, go to here emitter and all size I take 0 and 0. Yes, and guys, now I take cube. So cube size I take 10 cm, 10 and 10. Yes, and guys, select this one cube and make child with emitter. Yeah, and guys, select this emitter and I go to particle and show object check and play. Yes, guys, now I increase frame like 1000 and create full. Yes, right, that's my simple animation. Okay, so guys, now I create moving animation. So guys, go to object and chord and see guys, I change p.x size, this one like this. And guys, I go to zero frame and press this animation key. So this one, and guys, I go to 50 frame 50, and p dot x increase I take like, guys, 300 is good, 300, and check. And guys, go to 100 frames 100, and p dot x I take 0 and check. Simple guys, see. Yes, very nice. Okay, so guys, now I apply rigid body tag on here cube. Guys, go to simulation tag and use rigid body. Go to collision, bounce I take 0. Yes, and guys, go to here, that's my cylinder, and apply collider tag, and bounce I take 0 and friction take 100. Yes, and same, copy this tag. Yeah, and play. Yes, great. Okay, so guys, now create full. So go select this emitter and timeline F curve tool. Guys, select this curve tool and copy like this, and select and copy, and again select all and copy like this, and simple. Yes, Right guys, that's my keyframes. So go to back and play. Yeah, very nice. Okay, so guys, now I create rotation animation. So stop, select this cylinder and I go to chord and see guys, that's my rotation. So guys, go to zero frame and R.h take zero and press this animation key, go to 1000 frame and guys, randomly rotation, I take like 150, actually 1500 and check. Yes, and play. Okay, so guys, now I change some setting on collider tag. So guys, select this here cylinder and select this collider tag and guys, go to here collision and shape, I take static mesh and same tube and take same static mesh. Yes, and go to back and play. Yes, see guys, that's really good. Right, it's really good. Okay, so guys, now all is good. I stop this animation, stop, and guys, now I take matrix this one and select this object and matrix mode I take object and guys, select this emitter, drag and drop in object. Yes, and guys, go to distribution type, I take axis like this. And guys, you can hide this cube, hide and hide on render. Yeah. Okay, so guys, all is good and play. Yeah, very good. Okay, so guys, now stop. And guys, last one, I take tracer. So select this matrix and take tracer. Yes, see guys, tracer link is automatically matrix. And tracer mode, I take connect object to all, this one, connect all object. And guys, type, I take B spline. And intermediate point, I take natural. Yes. And play. Guys, again, you can hide this matrix, hide, and hide on render. So closer, like this. And play. Yes, guys, again, I change more setting. So guys, again, go to here and guys, you can decrease the speed. I take like 100. Yes. And guys, go to matrix. All is good. Go to tracer. Yeah, all is good. Go to back and play. Yes, guys, see, that's my random spline animation. Okay, so guys, now this time, guys, I apply meta tag. So use this meta ball and select this tracer and mix with meta tag. Yeah, and select this meta ball. Guys, hull value, I take, guys, like 600% and editor. I take guys like 3 and 3 and go to back and play. Yeah, guys, you can change this radius. So select this tracer and right click, go to cinema 4D tag and use meta ball tag. Yeah, and radius, I take guys, you can take like 5 and strength, I take 120%. Yes, and play. See guys, that's really smooth meta attack. Right? Okay, so guys, now I apply material for most visibility and I have already created materials. So select this flow and this one and change UV. Like cylindrical and gold material on meta ball. Yes, better. See guys, that's really good. Now, and guys, for lighting sky and apply sky material. And guys, last one, I take flow and select this flow, go to down and apply this pink material on flow. Yes. Guys, set camera angle like this and go to back and play. Guys, you can increase more smoothness. See, that's really beautiful. Guys, I apply more smoothness. So I take smooth tool, this one, and select and make child with meta ball. Yes. Now this is much smoother. Guys, you can increase radius. So radius, select this meta ball and radius, you can increase like 8 like this and play. See guys, right? That's really good. I really like this animation, guys. Okay, so guys, that's it. It's my final render. So go to render setting and guys, go to here, render setting and object, actually output all use frame and anti. Guys, if your system configuration is better, you can take best, otherwise geometry and ambient occlusion and global illumination. Global illumination, record density, I take low for fast render setting. And output, actually save JPEG sequences and go to desktop, create new folder and take any file name. That's it. And go to back and render, right? Okay guys, that's my simple, very simple, smooth as spline animation is finished. So if you like my video, please share and subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you.